Welcome back, everybody, to a Michigan State University that is led with energy on this here senior day. This is Big Ten Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus. I'm Brian Rector, and alongside me is Sarah Sageman, where Michigan State is hosting their first quad meet of the season. Now, to do that, they'll be alongside Fisk University, Greenville University, Central Michigan, and then the home team Michigan State Spartans. But to begin, for Fisk University, there is certainly one key contributor and all-around athlete that we must talk about.
Absolutely. That athlete is Morgan Price. She's an all-around competitor for Fisk. She is in her junior season, technically, even though this is only their second season of having gymnastics at their program. She was able to score a 9.95 on balance beam 2 weekends ago. That launched her to a personal best all-around score of 39.275. as well as that score set the program record for all-around total. They had a bye last weekend, so I know Morgan's looking to come out today and come back in right where she left off.
And for Greenville, more of the same. And I think, folks, you'll find that the key to each of these teams are their all-around athletes. For Greenville, it's Amara Nelson.
Absolutely. Amara is in her sophomore season this year. She's competed all around for them all season long. She is the anchor on their vault rotation as well as bars, and she's really looking to continue to push this program forward. This is the last meet of the season for Greenville, so know they would like to end on a high note today.
And for Central Michigan, as we begin the Michigan contingent, it's Lucy Alvardo Reed. Now, I had the opportunity to speak with an assistant coach within the athletic department at Central Michigan who offered one quick thought. She is their stud. Why is that?
Absolutely. So she is an all-around competitor as well for Central Michigan. She was able to score a 39.525 a couple of weekends ago at the end of February. That was the fifth highest all-around score for the program, a personal best for her, though, and she actually earned MAC Gymnast of the Week honors with that finish.
And for Michigan State, the Spartans looking to close out what has been a prominent year for the history of their program. One way they'll be able to do that is at the leadoff position on the floor with Ellie Beaufay.
Yes, Ellie has been a phenomenal leadoff competitor on the floor exercise for Michigan State all season long. She has competed in that position all but one meet of the season. Three of those meets, she's actually scored a 9.9 or higher in that leadoff spot, which is a phenomenal, huge score to start a rotation with. They're looking to do that again today.
With all that being said, we've got one more thing to do before we get off the ground here at Jennison Fieldhouse. Let's head down to floor side with Layla Pascal for more on what's happening today.
Thanks, Brian. Welcome down to the sideline, everyone. I'm Layla Pascal. Today, we're watching Michigan State, Fisk, Greenville, and Central Michigan compete while celebrating their senior day. And though it may be senior day for Michigan State and the other teams, Michigan State will continue on for one more quad meet leading into their spot at the Big Ten tournament. Today, I'll be interviewing fans and coaches, so stay tuned. I'm Layla Pascal. You're watching Women's Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus.
Welcome inside the electric and growing in atmosphere Jennison Fieldhouse, where we have Michigan State, the lone Big Ten team, in this quad taking on, as we've discussed, Fisk, Greenville, and Central Michigan. And initially, as I want to bring in here my color analyst, my question to you as we begin here is, when you're Michigan State, the lone Big Ten team, looking to compete in a environment such as this, where you're tuning up before Big Ten, how do they stay composed? How do they figure out how to hit their routines and work towards what's next without looking past today's meet?
That's a great thing to bring up, Brian. So in gymnastics, it's not always about wins and losses per se. Gymnastics does a cumulative scoring process, so they have what's called an NQS, a national qualifying score. So they're really looking today to compete within themselves to get a score that will continue to improve their NQS. So wins and losses aren't the direct comparison necessarily today, but improving upon scores.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Sarah, for the insight, and very happy that we're here alongside each other. Central Michigan beginning with Ashley Veglucci.
unfortunately starting with a fall here today. So it brings up an appropriate point for gymnastics. Six competitors compete per event. Only five scores count toward the team total, though. Now we're looking at Skyla here. Starting off on vault. Beautiful execution through the air for her. Nice amplitude off the table. And I'm pretty sure she got that stick. That was a great start for Michigan State.
Strong start for the Spartans. And especially, too, Skyla. Her last score, 98.5. I think that'll be even higher, presumably.
95, yes. She should be. It'd be right close to that. Sometimes those leadoff scores, they don't like to throw the really big scores in the very first routine. But we'll see what they give her.
Here it's Samantha Shannon, who sticks for Central Michigan.
So good comeback there for Samantha. She got a nice stick on that landing after the initial fall. Central will be looking to drop that score, hopefully, as they continue through the rotation. Looking at Greenville on beam here. So today, with all four teams competing at one time, that means literally every event has a competitor on it simultaneously. So you'll see a little bit of back and forth here of the gymnast as the day progresses.
It's Olivia Toko who's out there out of Trenton, Michigan.
And a gainer front full off the end for her dismount. Beautiful stick to finish for her.
Her previous score was 94.75. Up next for Michigan State there on vault, Olivia's on mark.
This is Michaela Tucker coming up here. Michaela is capable of doing a 1.5. We'll see what she competes today. Nice pop off the table, and she sticks her 1.5. Beautiful job for her. She was a little bit deep in the squat in her warm-up, so I'm great to see her find that landing that time.
Tucker out of Fishers, Indiana, her last score was 98.75. She's somebody who's come in and contributed very early in her career for Michigan State.
She has as a freshman. It's key for programs to be able to have those freshmen come in and get experience too early on for themselves, where you're not solely relying upon upperclassmen to bring in your scores. So she's done a great job for Michigan State thus far this season. It's like a little bit of a judge's discussion on bars after that fall for their leadoff routine. Sometimes judges have to discuss with one another if the start value of a routine, there's a discrepancy between the judges. Maybe one has a 9.9 and one might have a 10.0 start value. So they must decide between each other where the discrepancy lies to be able to correct it before they can let the next competitor go.
Certainly. And it's Quinn Scrupa for the Chippewas from Brandon, Manitoba, Canada. Her previous score, 96.25, as she begins here.
So important routine for Quinn here. Central is looking to drop that fall they had in the opening competitor. So Quinn's going to get the team back to good standings and hopefully get a hit here to keep things moving forward for them.
On the bars, it's Central Michigan, who's ranked 45th in the country.
Opening here, a little bit of a quick swing, kind of close to the bar on her catch of her Jaeger. She had to work through that well, but nice overshoot to handstand, working out of that catch. On bars, we're looking for handstands directly in the vertical position, looking for straight legs, strong, tight core through the middle of the swing. Beautiful double layout for her and a great stick. That was a great way to come back after a fall for Central.
And it's so important, especially early in the routine, when you have something like that happen.
And this is a look back. That was Olivia Zarmani that also got a stick on a 1.5 today.
That was the eruption that was heard from both of the Michigan crowds.
You're
Michigan
exactly
State
right.
Landing that.
Looking back over to Bean for Greenville here. Nice full turn. A full turn is a skill that is required from every gymnast in every routine on balance beam. And she's looking for her dismount. A round off, 1.5, I believe it was. And a slight scoop back for Gabby Douglas on that 1.5. She has flip-flopped this season between doing her Yurchenko full and Yurchenko 1.5. The difference there is your Chinko full is only worth a 9.95 start value. That is the highest score it can achieve, whereas the 1.5 can score from a 10.0. So they have looked to get that higher difficulty looking into postseason here and try to be consistent with it.
And Steven especially, too, is accustomed to just tremendously high scores. 995 is her career high.
Absolutely. The 995 she had gotten a few times last season on her Yurchenko full, which means technically it was the perfect score, being that the Yurchenko full was only worth a 9.95 from the start.
Jenna Germond from Neshanic, Pennsylvania, on the bars for Central Michigan. Her last score recorded was a 9.8.
And Jenna's doing well through the routine here. She got a little bit whippy on that pack salto to the low bar. And an interesting dismount for her. She had a toe shoot into a front tuck half. Nice to see some variance in the types of skills that are within the bar routines. Great job there from Jenna.
Nikki Smith readying here on the vault. Her last score was a 10, so that's something Michigan State has to enjoy.
Absolutely. Nikki's looking to get that landing again today. She has such pretty execution. Oh, a little bit too much power today. So that step forward will cost her pretty largely. The judges can take up to 2 or 3 tenths on landing deductions, depending on how large of a step they incur. So if it's within a shoulder width of a step, it's only 1/10. But anything beyond that can be up to 2 or 3. She might get hit pretty hard on that one just because there was such a large over-rotation.
We're getting a look there at Amara Nelson on the beam, who was one of the highlight players we touched on in the open, and for quite a few reasons. They're having a discussion with a coach as she begins her work for Greenville.
Absolutely. Amara's that all-around gymnast we had opened with discussing in the beginning of the broadcast today. So she's been a solid competitor, consistent across the board for them this season.
And who else but to follow Nikki Smith is Sage Kellerman, the sensational sophomore. She's responsible for 2 tens this season as well, and that just shows the depth Michigan State has.
You're absolutely right. It's incredible to have two competitors back-to-back like this for Michigan State that are both capable of scoring tens on any given day. Sage does a little bit of a different entry on her vault. She does a front handspring front pike half, so she enters the table facing forward. Beautiful execution again, nice amplitude there. A small hop backwards, about a 10th or so deduction for that one, but a very nice vault rotation for Michigan State to begin the meet. Looking over at Central as they're wrapping up with the dismount here. A full in. She picked her foot up just a bit on the ending of that dismount, but they're happy with that routine.
Adriana Bustello contributed that score out of Mason, Ohio. Her previous score was a 9.525, and as it stands, Michigan State leads with 49.35 through their vault rotation.
You're exactly right. Actually up to just a 49.45 just now as Sage Kellerman's score got updated into that rotation score. So that's a great start for Michigan State. Amara is doing her beam routine here. A nice aerial into a split jump. Beam routines require a combination of an acro skill accompanied with a leap skill. Bailey Garcia doing a Yurchenko full. Beautiful landing for her. A slight pike down on the ending of that layout position, but very nicely executed for Bailey.
Continuing on to watch Nelson here on beam.
And a switch leap into a split three-quarter.
She's out of Lincoln, Nebraska, and has recorded a 9.725 for the 79th ranked unit in the country.
And a beautiful 1.5 to finish that routine off of her. That was a very nice routine from Amara, continuing with that consistency for her team.
And a celebration there for good reason, but not before we head back over to Luciana Alvarado Reed.
Absolutely. Lucy is the competitor that we also mentioned in the open. A nice routine on bars for her there. Looking to continue that all-around trend for her of putting up those big scores for Central. And another Yurchenko layout full. for Michigan State. That was Tara Walsh this time. And as a senior, this is a trend, a tradition, I'm sorry, for Michigan State to throw flowers on the last routine that you compete at home. So that's why all you saw those carnations coming in for her. So good for Tara to be able to close out as an exhibition gymnast today on senior night and get that last routine in, praise from her teammates, and bittersweet moment for Tara.
Now as we are seeing the floor here for Fisk University. The exhibition, the sixth there, the anchor for Central Michigan, Gabrielle Johnson for the Chippewas.
And a beautifully done handstand there to finish up this routine. Full pirouette, nicely finished right on the top of the bar after that full pirouette. And almost got the stick. She had her chest a little bit forward on herself that time, so she had to take a small step to compensate. But very nice execution throughout that routine. Beautiful pointed toes. And looking at Greenville on balance beam again, a switch leap to a wolf jump three quarters. She lacked a little bit of amplitude and positioning on that wolf jump. The judges would like to see the wolf position be parallel to the floor, so the front leg should be all the way lifted. Nice front aerial there, though, to come back with.
Dory Shelton here from Maynardsville, Tennessee, 9.5 her recent score.
And a gainer pike off the end for her dismount. A step forward for that. Back to central on bars here. She mounts from the high bar. Nice casting handstand, maybe barely shy of that vertical position. But beautiful toe shoot to reverse hecht. She did hit her feet on the floor just a little bit after that shoot over. The judges will have to take a deduction for that. Nice casting handstand, though. She also has beautiful execution, nice long lines. And didn't get quite enough height on her double layout. She ended up with a little bit of buckle knees and had to step forward, but did not take a fall at all. So good adjustment there for Central.
Certainly, and especially too, I think it's a unique scenario we have today where it's a quad, and that means that the floor and beam will be offsetting and take a little bit longer traditionally. So we do have a few more athletes for both Greenville and Fisk on the beam and floor respectively.
You're right, Brian. Bars and vault are quicker rotations in terms of the length of time it takes for the routine to finish. Beam and floor are a minute and 30 seconds per routine, plus the judging time in between. So they do take a little bit longer to finish out, but that's great because we'll get to see more floor routines. Lots of fun energy here on the floor from Fisk. Her leap pass, switch side, straddle full. Judges are looking for those split positions to be 180 degrees at the minimum. It's fun to see the personality of the gymnast in floor routines. As we watch more routines go by, you'll notice each gymnast picks their own music, has their own variation of types of dance that they do. Finishing with the last pass here. 1.5 punch front pike. And she is having a great time out there. Beautiful routine for Fisk.
And that was Zaya Coleman out of Atlanta, Georgia, who her recent score, a 9.475, we'll see what comes in for her.
Switch leap, tuck three quarters for that leap pass on Greenville and beam. Again, that required full turn. Taking a little bit of a breath here before she comes back for her next element. Cat leap. Aerial cartwheel. A slight adjustment she had to make to stay on the beam for that, but good to take that correction versus have a fall. And a gainer pike off the end. A little bit of a hop backwards. Nice routine, though. Good hit for Greenville on beam. Central was able to finish their bar rotation out with a 49.025 for their opening rotation. They did a great job not having to count that initial fall they had as their leadoff competitor made the mistake. So the rest of the team was able to have her back and got hits the remainder of the way through.
And for Fisk now, we'll see Jada Reese for the 77th ranked unit in the country, and Reese out of Grantville, Georgia. Her last score, 9.65.
Jada's starting off with some good dance moves here, hyping up the crowd. Her teammates are loving it on the sidelines with her, too. In her opening pass, she does a front through, round off by cane spring 2.5. Very nice, again, to see some of that differing types of tumbling passes. The 2.5 twist is not one you see as frequently. Unfortunately, she did step out of bounds on that, which means her foot left the sideline marker that was noted on the mat there. That is a 1/10 deduction for an out of bounds.
So how do the first and second passes on the floor, do they differentiate at all? What is different about what you aim to accomplish on them?
So most often, your very first pass that you do on floor, the opening pass, has the one with the most difficulty. So it'd be the hardest one to do when you have the most energy. In college gymnastics, it's become a trend more to have only two passes, actually, which looks like that's what we're going to see in this floor routine, a very beautiful double pike coming back for pass number two. So it used to be a requirement that routines needed to have three tumbling passes. They have since adjusted that to needing only two tumbling passes, and that helps to save the athletes' bodies a little bit. There's not so much pounding on them throughout the long season that they endure. So it's up to the gymnast at this point which they would like to do, two or three. They could be up to their own discretion.
Now it's Ashley League on the beam for Greenville.
And she's finishing up with a cartwheel. Gainer full off the side. Beautiful form on that dismount, and she definitely is showing that hold position to finish her routine.
Out of Paulsboro, Washington, her last score was a 9.625, and she certainly did nothing to jeopardize their finishing score on that routine.
So Ashley showed a good example there of a newer rule that's been put into place for collegiate gymnastics as well, is that you must hold your finishing position for at least 1 second before turning to salute to the judge. We used to have something that we all like to deem the college stick, where your feet would touch the ground and then you turn and salute quickly to try to eliminate deductions that were taken. But they've gotten rid of that. So now the gymnast must hold for 1 second prior to making any kind of move toward a salute to the judge.
Now we're continuing on here through the remainder of rotation one with Fisk University on the floor.
And this is going to be Morgan Price, whom we discussed in the open. She is an all-around competitor for them. And she is typically at the end of the rotation per each event. Morgan had that 39.275 personal best all-around score. I know she's looking to recreate that today.
It's Price out of Lebanon, Tennessee, who really has, as we said, been dominant. Her recent score on the floor was 9.725.
Absolutely. Morgan opens with a very nicely done double pike. She tried to open a little bit early. It looked like maybe trying to go for the stick on that skill instead of taking the lunge backwards. You are allowed to take a controlled lunge backwards without a deduction. I'm very much enjoying the choreography of these Fisk routines. They're having a great time out here. And Morgan comes back with a front layout, punch front full. A very nice landing on that pass. Her leap pass, split full. Judges are looking to make sure that each of those twisting elements starts and finishes in the same place. So if your feet do not quite close 360 degrees all the way around, that can be a deduction. And Morgan does this three pass routine. So she's moving back to the corner to finish up her last pass. Around if I can spring 2.5. Beautifully done. Again, that slight hop forward for herself, so she did go out of bounds. That was two routines that Fisk will have to have that out of bounds deduction for. But beautiful height on that 2.5. It was nicely done.
So, not too much separation really between 1 and 2 at the very least, Michigan State and Central Michigan. Barring any last alterations to scores, it's 49.45 in favor of Michigan State to 49.025 for Central Michigan. And then it's Fisk followed by Greenville.
Absolutely. That was a nice opening rotation for all teams. They'll be looking to keep building scores as the afternoon moves forward here. Fisk has a couple of exhibition competitors still yet to go. So exhibition routines are often used to get exposure for the athlete, get in front of the judge, kind of have some ability to see what the score might incur for that routine. It helps build lineup down in the future. So these routines do not count toward the team total for Fisk. They are just extra practice, essentially, for those gymnasts.
And for Fisk and their floor routine, it's Zona Brewer, who hasn't recorded a score to this point in Exhibition 1. She's out of Dallas, Texas, though, and I think that just speaks to your point about seeing the exposure and understanding where you can go with your lineups as you move forward.
Absolutely, and sometimes for this exhibition routine, if this is her first time competing it, it might be if there are some injuries or things that maybe they're trying to help some gymnasts work through. They know they have this routine in their back pocket that she could step into the lineup at any point and be able to compete for someone else if that's needed. And the judges are finishing up with their scoring of the prior routine, and she's ready to take the floor. She comes for her first pass. Round off 1.5, front layout. Nice open. That is her 2-salto pass, which means she flipped without using her hands twice in sequence. And switch side, straddle full. See teammates doing the routine with her on the sidelines. You get to where you end up knowing each other's floor routines pretty well, forward and backwards, after doing them so many times in practices. And she's working toward the corner here. A wolf 1.5, I believe she was aiming for. She was a little bit shy of that second half. So her feet touch the ground more at the 3/4 spot instead. Or sorry, the 1.25 spot. She comes back with a round if I can't spring double pike. Well done. She stayed in bounds. She stepped forward for her lunge. Did not incur that out of bounds deduction for stepping backwards. But nice routine to have for Fisk as that exhibition routine, especially her first time competing it. We're looking back here at a couple of routines while we have a moment. This is routine on bars. That dismount from the undershoot into the toe front half. Looking at a secondary dismount, a full in. Beautifully done full pirouette right on top of the bar for that finishing position.
Waiting for the finishing touches here are the Central Michigan Chippewas, who just gave a salute to us. So shout out to the Chippewas for that, noticing that they were on the Jumbotron here in Jennison Fieldhouse.
Sana Brewer got a 9.75 on that floor routine, so that's a great exhibition score. Good for Fisk to know they have that routine, like I said, in their back pocket. They can use that at any time, plug and play into their lineup, and know they can still get a consistent score from her. And then look back and recap here at some of the Greenville routines. That handspring layout step out. On beam, you're looking for long straight lines through legs for the judges to not take any execution deductions. That was a nice aerial to a split jump.
And there, seeing a look at Greenville, but not before, though, we're moving on to Kiana Session for Fisk on the floor, rounding out their lineup out of Chandler, Arizona. She also has not recorded a score to this point.
Kiana did a beautiful roundfoot handspring double tuck to open with. Nice landing on that. She had a lot of height on that opening pass.
And it's Naima Muhammad, actually, for Fisk on the floor. Not Kiana Session, as we had previously noted, but with that being said, really solid start for Muhammad.
And you'll notice she actually has on tights for competing in. She actually petitioned to the NCAA to be able to wear those for religious purposes, and they agreed clearly upon that decision for her. So it's nice to be able to make those exceptions in NCAA gymnastics. And a front full to a front tuck, beautifully done for her there as well. And switch ring, tourjete full, split full. Very nicely done lead pass for her. And nice routine. Fisk has a couple of great exhibitions, especially if these are the first time competing these routines. These girls have done a beautiful job.
And the celebration, I think, there for Muhammad shows just how important it is to be excelling at not only the 1-6, but then even the 7th and 8th competitors here for Fisk.
Absolutely. That's great to see the depth that Fisk has on floor. Hopefully they can have that depth, too, coming up on the other events. It's fun to see their program continuing to build as the years are moving forward. So fun to see the interaction between gymnast and coach there as well. She was so happy. Moving back down to a beam routine as a recap, a handspring layout step out.
With that being said, after you see the central rounding out of the bars, we're going to head to break, but this is Brian Rector alongside Sarah Sageman on Big Ten Plus with Big Ten Gymnastics. Welcome back inside Jennison Fieldhouse, and we've reached the end of one rotation where now there have been adjustments made and conversations had within each one of these teams, and it's Michigan State who's moving to the uneven bars, which really is head coach Mike Rowe's specialty.
It is, you're right. This is the one that Mike technically coaches, although he's the head coach and, of course, does lots of other things as well. But yes, Michigan State will move in the order that we call Olympic order. So they go vault, bars, beam, and floor. So Skyla is the lead off for Michigan State today. Nice cast to handstand. Shaposhnik over to the high bar. And bailed a handstand coming down to the low bar for that transition element. Cast handstand right to vertical for her on this leading up to her dismount. And had to step forward on the dismount, so did not get the stick for that. But nice routine otherwise. So your Yurchenko layout for Fisk to open as their leadoff competitor. There are lines on the matting for vault that are newer to collegiate gymnastics as well within the last couple of years. Those lines can show directional deductions per the gymnast that the judges can take.
And that was Brianna Daniels for Fisk to open on the vault. Now over to the beam with Central Michigan and Ashley Veglucci.
Ashley does a side summy. Kind of a unique skill there. It's a fun one. It is intended to have bent legs like that, so that is not a deduction. And she is finishing with a round off double full. Beautiful stick to her to finish.
Veglucci out of Coram, New York. Her last score was a 9.725. Michigan State and Jory Jackard entering the bar area. One of the seniors for Michigan State.
Absolutely. And Jory scored a 10 last year on bar, so she's looking to come back with a big score for Michigan State today. Beautifully done so far. Jory has very nice execution, meaning straight legs, pointed toes, all throughout the skill. She does a full pirouette into a double tuck dismount here, looking for the stick, and she gets it. Beautiful job for Jory, and again, that is her senior year last event to compete, so the roses come out.
And you see how much it means to the program to have a tradition like that. You see the eruption from Coach Rowe, who traditionally brings tremendous amounts of energy, but even there you could tell that was unique. That was something that's different from normal.
Absolutely. It's such a fun tradition that Michigan State has here. It's such a bittersweet moment, like I mentioned before, when Tara was finishing her vault. So it's excitement mixed with a little bit of sadness, but just appreciation too for the time you're able to spend as a Michigan State gymnast. These are her parents on the sidelines that get to watch from the edge.
Central Michigan now on the beam, and Katrina Langkamer out of Flemington, New Jersey, and she is responsible for a 98.25.
Olivia Zarmani is on bars here. She opens with her pack salto to the low bar, so her transition skill. She actually does two of those transitions. She'll posh back up to the high bar and an in-bar ginger. So she does three release moves, adds an extra difficulty. And a slight hop backwards on her landing for the double layout, on her dismount.
Zarmani, her last score, a 9.875, career high 9.9. She's one who can certainly elevate her score on the bars.
She can, absolutely. And Olivia takes those risks with having the extra difficulty for the third release move. It is not a requirement in the collegiate code of points, but it's nice to see her take that risk and have some of the higher difficulty come along in the routine. And kick over front to a back handspring as the series here for Central Michigan. Pass is a switch leap, sheep jump, beautifully done. So that skill is one where the gymnast's eyes look up toward the ceiling. That means they lose sight of the balance beam below them. So it's a very hard skill to land and not have execution deductions for. And a round off 1.5 dismount. Small hop forward, but that was a beautiful routine for Central. Gabby Steven looking to start her routine for bars here for Michigan State. Cast handstand, toe shoot to handstand. Maloney to the high bar. Back down to the bail to handstand. Working through the remainder of the routine, a beautiful cast to handstand to show that vertical position. She does a full in and a tuck position and got the stick. Very nice routine from Gabby. You can hear the crowd erupt for that one.
Continuing here to do really, really solid work is Michigan State on the bars, and Steven should be looking for about her last score, which was 9.825, her career high at 9.975. So just evading the 10 mark as you're seeing the score pop in, Michigan State at 59.25 to this point.
That should be a big score for Steven there on that routine. Looking at floor here for Greenville. This is the last pass in this floor routine.
Isabella Feltman here for Greenville.
Round off 1.5, punch front layout. Nicely done. Her 2 salto pass was done at the end of the routine. And they're happy with that routine. So fun to see the excitement from her teammates for her.
Feltman out of China Grove, North Carolina. Her last score, 9.35. We'll see what she does there. And it's Michigan State back here on bars with Sage Kelly.
Absolutely, a beautiful Jaeger that she did there to start, and then the shoot over the handstand on the low bar. Nice handstand for her to finish. Kind of held that one a little bit to show the judges I've got this. Double layout. Her chest was forward on the end of the double layout. Didn't quite have enough rotation to finish and get that stick. So small step forward will be a deduction. Probably the only one through that routine that I saw.
Now a serious celebration for the Chippewas over there on the beam.
Central's had some good routines coming up thus far in their rotation. They've had sticks the whole way through. They're continuing to build excitement as the rotation proceeds.
That was Samantha Shannon for Central Michigan. Taking a look here at the vault for Fisk University.
So many things happening at one time. It's always hard to know which ones to watch when. And Delaney Harkness is doing her bar routine for Michigan State. Beautifully executed ginger into her bail to handstand. Delaney's legs are glued together the entirety of her bar routine. Nicely done on that casting handstand, looking for the stick for her dismount, see if she can get it. And she did. Those should be a couple of great scores finishing it out for Michigan State on bars.
Now, when you're looking at your sight line as you move from bar to bar, what are some of the tips and tricks as you're negotiating between the two?
Absolutely. So when you're looking as a gymnast, when you're competing, you're more so relying upon body awareness and feel of the skill. So when you get to a situation like this, it's really just about letting your body execute the skills that you've done time and time again. And you really don't think too much about it versus just kind of give mental cues to keep yourselves in the right positioning.
Amber Mueller out of Wheaton, Illinois, her recent score, 9.175.
Amber's looking very confident during this beam routine here. Again, producing another hit for Central. Looking for this dismount. Cartwheel swing through to 1.5, and she fought for that stick on the landing. Judges could take a slight deduction on the swing of the arms, but otherwise, great routine. An exhibition here for Sydney Hayashi on bars for Michigan State. setting up for her dismount, getting some power momentum from those giants. And a double layout, small step backwards. Again, nice exhibition to have for Michigan State to get some scores in these routines and see what the gymnast can produce.
And Hayashi there, out of Ohio, is another one of the seniors to be celebrated, and one that has continued to find ways to contribute. And I think she's one that, when you speak about Michigan State, her name is mentioned in terms of the leadership ability and her ability to contribute to morale and energy and control over the team as being one of the more experienced.
You're absolutely right. And sometimes being the competitor itself is not necessarily the most important part of a team atmosphere. So having those competitors that may or may not compete as often, but really keep the team camaraderie up, they keep everyone excited, they build that core unit of respect and love for one another. Those key components like that on a team are just as valuable as, say, your highest number all-around gymnast.
And for Michigan State, Naomi German awaiting her opportunity on the bars.
Naomi, again, a senior, so it's nice to get this senior in these exhibition positions for the night. A blind change into a Jaeger, beautifully done for her. Oh, bailed handstand, she's working through it though. She missed her hand on the catch of that bail, but good for her to keep moving forward. Nice full pirouette and double tuck dismount. And great job for Naomi. Again, not quite flawless through the routine, but in order to work through that mistake, it's great to see her keep moving and not make that a fall on the apparatus.
The balance beam here for Central Michigan, and Quinn Skrupa has the look here.
And Quinn's completing her full turn. She has nice posture on this event. Chest is lifted, her chin's kind of up, not just staring at the balance beam the whole time. She has a front aerial into a split jump. Well done there. Showing some flexibility here through the dance skills. Quinn is coming back with her dismount, back handspring, 1.5 in a tuck position. Small step backwards, so a backwards step shows under rotation, versus if you were to step forward, it shows the judge that you were over rotated. They can take a bigger deduction for under rotation, meaning you did not finish the skill fully before your feet hit the ground. But nice routine, solid up there finish for the central.
And the gold chain adorning the neck of Skrupa, she's one who on the vault recorded a 9.825. It's been a good day for her and the Central Michigan Chippewas to this point.
Absolutely. I'm assuming that gold chain is their hit chain. So if you stay on the apparatus, you get the chain after the fact, maybe? It's like a turnover chain in football.
Certainly. A look at Greenville there as they're continuing to work through on the floor. Hugs all around. Look at that chain. It's practically weighing her down there.
That's something. I like it. I'm all about that added excitement for sure. I couldn't quite see the medallion that hangs from it, though.
And I know it's Michigan State that over the course of time has wielded a shield, and today they have the roses, so it's all about the pageantry and the celebration as a part of this quad here between these four squads.
You're exactly right. It's fun to have some of those little added elements that just make it exciting. It brings some joy into the competition as well.
Awaiting scores to be coming in and at a little bit of a lull in the action here. Thank you so much for being with us today, as this is a unique opportunity for us to do a quad prior to what's happening as a part of the Big Ten Conference Championships coming up in just a few weeks.
A couple of weeks, we'll be right back here. Yes, Michigan State is hosting Big Tens 2 weeks from now. So Jennison is set up a little bit differently today as a test run for that competition coming up. Nice routine so far for Central and Beam. Flutter kick to a front aerial. Slight balance check at the end of the front aerial, but she compensated well. Switch leap, she has beautiful toe point throughout these leap skills. She did switch leap to a switch leap half as her series, her leap series.
Alvarado Reed here for Central Michigan. Her last score, 9.875.
And she does a pipe gainer off the end of the beam, small hop backwards. But again, a nice execution through that routine. Beautifully done for Central.
Now, with a late season update that we're seeing, a comparison between each four, Greenville, Fisk, Central Michigan, and then Michigan State. And now I find it so fascinating, the difference between who you see on the right side, Central Michigan, with the NQS of 195.5, Michigan State 197, and the other two at 190.5 for Greenville, and then it drops off there for Fisk at 183. What contributes to the NQS?
You're right. So NQS, like I mentioned, is the national qualifying score. What they do is they take three away meets, three home meets, and average those totals together. You drop the high score actually out of those totals. So it offsets any discrepancy you may have at a home meet versus an away meet for judging if there are discrepancies in that. But what we're really seeing here is that Greenville and Fisk are both brand new programs. So they're each in their second season of having a gymnastics program entirely. So it's great to see these new programs adding gymnastics into their athletic repertoire. And then for these girls to come out and really be part of these inaugural seasons and be making history for their colleges. So it's great to see them continuing to kind of build scores. They've been doing better as the season has moved forward. So it'll be great to see what they can produce as the years come once they get down the line. Michigan State is in its 50th year of having gymnastics. So they've had much more season time to be able to get these scores increased through their program.
And there's a look at Greenville. For the time being, Central Michigan getting work done on the beam here in their preparation period before this next series that we'll see.
This is an exhibition competitor finishing up for Central. Looking at her dismount. Round off 1.5, beautifully stuck dismount for her there. And there is one more competitor to go for Central in those exhibition positions. Also an extra competitor for Greenville. We'll look to this floor team. She opens with a round off, double pipe. She actually did that a little differently than most gymnasts do. Typically there's a back handspring in between the round off and the double pipe. She either opts to not do one just for personal preference or maybe to help with an injury that she has, seeing that brace on her knee. Backwards with a front layout, punch front full. A little bit of a step forward, not quite that controlled lunge the judges like to see. She pulled her head forward a little bit as she landed there.
In this for Greenville, Rachel Miller out of Canton, Georgia, registering at 9.725 the last time out.
She's having a good time down there. It's fun to see the big smile. And she's gearing up for her last pass. Again, does just a round off into a double tuck. Nicely done. This is a good routine for Greenville. And that will wrap up the rotation for Greenville on floor.
Central Michigan now on the beam. And Elizabeth Cesarone, it appears, will be on the beam now for Central Michigan. And rather, no, it's Zoe Pelfrey who will be finishing for Central Michigan.
This is their second exhibition competitor. She does an aerial. I believe she was trying to connect that to another skill. So that means if that was intended to be her series, she will need to repeat that process again in order to get credit for it. We'll see what she comes back with now. Switch leap, split three quarters.
Pelfrey out of Westchester, Ohio, and has been a contributor at times on the vault as well.
So that was the series there that she had a mishap on the first time she attempted it. So it was a side aerial into a round off. That gets her the requirement made for the acro series. So she came back and repeated the skill and got full credit. Nice dismount for her as well there. Way to think on her toes for that routine.
We are continuing to see scores come in, and as it stands, it's Michigan State 98.925 to Central Michigan's 98.1. Fisk following at 96.15, and Greenville there at 95.525. And as we're seeing the judges there in the middle of the floor taking a look at their score sheets respectively.
Fisk made some good gains on that second rotation here where they upped the ante on their team total.
And with that being said, we've reached the completion of two rotations here as a part of the Michigan State quad with Greenville, Fisk, and Central Michigan, and we're headed on the way to break. But thank you so much for being with us. This is Big Ten Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus.
Welcome back, everybody. You're watching Women's Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus here at Jennison Fieldhouse. I'm Layla Pascal. Alongside me is head coach Mike Rowe from Michigan State. Coach, what does it feel like in a quad meet? Where does your mindset go in order to come out on top by the end of the night?
I think what's nice about a quad like this is we're not waiting alternating routines, so waiting for a routine to finish before we can start, so it's not all eyes on our competitor or whatever. We're staying in our own little bubble anyway, and when we can just run the lineup and it's in the judges' control as to when you go and stuff, it kind of takes one of the stressors away. So they can go when the judge is ready to go, they put up the green flag and go, and we're not caring or having time to watch anybody else's routine. I think that eliminates one more stressor, which I think makes it that much easier.
Absolutely. I never thought about it like that. So you think it does really take a lot of the pressure off of the girls and they look forward to quad meets?
Yeah, oh, definitely. I think so. And just a personal opinion, they seem a little bit more relaxed. So, you know, typically when they tense up on my event, there's short handstands, they don't stick landings. And I was just really proud of what the girls, you know, 8 for 8 to go today and get a pretty decent score.
Amazing. Thank you so much. It's always a pleasure talking with you. Have a great rest of the meet. I'm Layla Pascal. Thank you for joining us here down on the sideline. We'll see you soon.
Oh, now you're getting a look at us. They're inside the booth here. So thank you so much for being alongside us. And what are your impressions through two rotations?
So it's been a busy meet for sure. Michigan State's coming out strong. They've done well on both events thus far. No, haven't had to count any falls or had any falls period yet, which is great to see. Central saying they had a fall to open the rotation, but they've built since that time and they did a great job on balance beam. Fisk struggled a little bit on floor, but came back really well after that. And the second rotation was able to make some gains on Greenville. So it's looking good so far.
Certainly. And I loved what Coach Rowe said about how the eyes are off of the competitors because they're moving around so often and looking at these four different places.
That's very true. So it takes a little bit of the pressure off. With dual meets where it's only two teams competing, there's that wait for the back and forth flip-flop. So once you finish your routine, you have to wait for the next event to finish theirs, and it gets a little bit of a lull between. So it's nice you kind of stay in your own bubble. Once your own competitor on your team is finished, you're ready to go right up right away after that. So
would you say that's more challenging when you have to wait as an athlete, when you're waiting for your turn? How does that work, kind of mentally thinking through that?
It is typically that. So in gymnastics in general, you try to kind of stay out of your own head a little bit. So just rely on mental cues, rely on your own training. But when you have those extra lulls of having to stand still and just waiting and waiting, it does create some additional mental aspect of second guessing yourself a bit. So being able to keep rolling forward and moving in a quicker manner is helpful.
Michigan stayed up by nearly 8 or nearly 9 tenths, really, at 98.925. And as well, it'll be Michigan State who's headed over to the beam, and leading off for them will be Gianna Khalifi.
See some of the fans in the stands here brought their fire today.
Fire up chips. There it is. I love that. I'm not sure if that was an emoji that was printed off or what that was, but
I don't know. I like it.
One thing's for sure is that was certainly cool. A look there at Gianna Khalifi as she's headed to the beam out of Corona, California. Her last score, a 9.9.
You're right. And at the moment, we are looking at their touch warm-up. So gymnasts come in typically a two-hour window prior to the beginning of the meet itself and do all of their skills, stretch, get everything warmed up, and practice it beforehand. So this moment is just one last little ability to touch the beam. They've been standing around for a little while, especially if you're only competing on one or two events. So Gianna gets up. They kind of come in sequence of each other and just do a couple little skills for their touch, it's called.
So when you're in this period of practicing and feeling it through as you are preparing to do it live, is there anything that you're holding back, or are you giving everything you have in the prep period?
That tends to vary per the gymnast. You wouldn't want to hold anything back necessarily, but sometimes, depending on if you want to do what we call a timer, where you maybe do half of the skill and not the full value of this skill through. Some gymnasts will do those. Some gymnasts will get up and almost do an entire routine. It just depends on what their preference is and where their comfort zone lies in terms of what they feel like they need before they actually get up and compete.
Yes. Absolutely. And look at these vivacious fans here for Central Michigan, bringing all of the stops out with the pom-poms and the emojis. I can't get over that. That is just necessary.
It's fun. It's fun to have excitement in the stands. It's fun for the competitors to see people supporting them. We have a pretty big crowd here tonight for this afternoon for the quad meet. So again, it's fun to have that excitement in the stands, and the gymnasts really love that. Might also be embarrassed by it if it's your own mother that's doing it, but par for the course.
Absolutely. As there's a look there at Fisk and seeing what they're getting ready for on the bars, what would you like to see from them as they're continuing to move through?
So Fisk, like I said, had a little bit of some trouble on their opening floor rotation, but came back much stronger on vault and were able to offset some of those scores, kind of get the higher scores moving forward again. So on bars, just looking to continue to build for them, looking for hit routines, nice execution, keeping that momentum moving forward, and excitement, support for each other throughout the rotation. This is a look at Central Michigan's highest score they received on balance beam.
Now, Michigan State there in Central Michigan, as we're seeing looks sweeping around the gym. We're headed down to an interview with Layla Pascal alongside Corinna Tarver, the Fisk University head coach. Take it away, Layla.
Thanks, Brian. Welcome back to the sideline. I'm here with head coach from Fisk, Coach Kareen. How are you feeling about today's score so far?
Well, I'm excited. We got the highest score so far for our team on floor. So season high, a little late, but that's okay. We'll take it. And vaulting was a little rough, but you know, we're gonna come back. We have bars and I'm excited for the next two events.
Amazing. And is there anything that your team has been practicing leading up to this meet or future meets that you think has really shown tonight?
Well, yeah, it's about being confident. You know, I have a very young team, so they haven't been in a lot of meets, some of them. You know, the freshmen, or the sophomores, I should say, they're used to it, but the freshmen, it's still so new for them, and they're still learning how to compete when they're in a big arena, and it's really loud, and it, you know, the fans are going crazy for the other team or any team, so they have to learn how to get through that and to be successful, and they're getting there.
Amazing. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure to talk to you. We're going to send it back to our announcers up in the booth. Thanks for joining me. I'm Layla Pascal.
Thank you so much, Layla. And confidence is key for Fisk University and Coach Tarver over there. They're headed to the bars. We'll see what they can do. But I think after hearing her, the tranquility, the calmness that she has about her, I would be excited and ready to go if I were Fisk.
I think you're absolutely right, Brian. Yes, they're in the right mindset. They're moving forward, continuing to build, like she said, as the meet is moving forward. So it's nice to see them have that positivity from their head coach.
Now we're seeing a look at Greenville and Ellie Schneiders on the vault.
And Ellie did a Yurchenko layout. She didn't get into the table at the proper angle, so she was not able to get much height off of the table, which is why she landed so scrunched on the landing itself. Hopefully she's okay after that vault.
Michigan State now on the beam here, beginning with Gianna Khalifi out of Corona, California.
Gianna's been a solid leadoff competitor for Michigan State on beam all season through for a couple of seasons now. She has a just calm presence about herself. It takes a certain type of gymnast to be in that leadoff role, and she certainly exhibits all the characteristics of this leadoff competitor. Beautifully done on her triple series by Kaysenberg handspring layout step out. It was a very solid finish. Nice leap pass for her there. She has a little bit of personality within her dance up on the beam. And coming back with her dismount, cartwheel, gainer full, and a stuck dismount. Stuck landing for her. Again, another solid performance from Gianna in that leadoff position.
Certainly was. And you know, it was worth noting that Schneiders, the initial vaulter, was awarded at 8.725 there. And I think this is chance to be a really, really high score to dictate the pace for the Spartans on the beam.
You're absolutely right. That should be a big score, certainly, for Gianna.
Let's take a look now at Central Michigan and Quinn Skrupa, beginning on the floor here.
So Quinn opens with a front layout, front full. Again, sufficing her two salto pass requirement for the routine.
And I do apologize. It's Elizabeth Butter who's on the floor here for the chip waltz.
It's the fun, upbeat music she has. She has the personality to go with it.
Buttle out of Shaftesbury, Vermont, is good for her recent score at 9.85.
And she's coming back for her last pass. Right off back handspring, double tuck. Nice controlled lunge there. Lots of excitement from the stands as well. Straddle full, wolf full, beautiful routine to open for Central. Greenville vault. She did a round off half onto the table, half off a back tuck afterwards. Again, a unique vault to see from Greenville. Very well done. Michaela Tucker now is a second competitor for Michigan State. A little bit of a slight adjustment through the dance skill there. Lost her core just a bit, but was able to fix it as she danced through.
Her last score, 9.85 on the beam.
That cat leap aside aerial was very well done. And the required full turn. Okay, working into her series here. Oh, I'm sorry, her dismount, backhand spring, swing through to a gainer full and gets the stick. Nice second routine for Michigan State.
Now taking a look over at the bars for Fisk University after hearing from head coach Corinna Tarver. I'm curious to see what we'll see from them on the uneven bars.
We're checking in after the opening pass here for Central. She did a front full to a front layout. And a double pike, beautiful height on that. Nice controlled lunge backwards. Central's bringing it on floor for sure.
Elizabeth Cesarone out of Lancaster, Pennsylvania. Last score, 9.725 for her.
She's completed her lead pass already. So she's moving to the corner for her last tumbling pass. Finishing up with a double tuck. A little bit bouncy on the landing. She didn't quite absorb the landing as her feet hit the ground. But that's going to be a nice score for Central.
We'll see what the evaluation looks like after that one. But I do agree, and I think that entire squad agrees as well, seeing that they were actively out there to greet her and celebrate with her. Michigan State here in Delaney Harkness on the beam for the Spartans. And it's Harkness out of Leslie, Michigan. Her last score was a 9.9 as an exhibition at Gymnastics.
Yes, Delaney's been in and out of the lineup, different meets through the course of her time here at Michigan State on balance beam. So she's working beautifully through this routine so far. Her series was very well executed. Looking for her leap pass here. Switch leap, switch leap. Again, nice control in that landing. She was able to hit the 180 required degrees on the leap positioning. Enter aerial. Solid so far. Moving through to her dismount. Cat leap, aerial, tuck 1.5, and gets the stick. Great way for Delaney to step into that lineup today.
Central Michigan here on the floor.
Showing some fun choreography on this floor rotation for them.
And Alvarado Reed has the look at it this time for the Chippewas.
She's had a strong competition so far in her third rotation now in the all-around competition.
Her last score on the floor, a 9.175. And really, Sarah, I would not be surprised if she finds a way to increase that score here today.
Absolutely. The 1.975 is definitely an out-of-character for her in terms of the score. She must have had a fall in that routine. But certainly she can build upon that today. Looking great over here so far. Showing some fun energy on this dance element here at the end of the routine. That should be a big score for Central. Nicely done.
And now we'll look at the phenom for Michigan State. That's Skyla Schulte, who's positioning herself on the beam. And it's worth mentioning, folks, that Central Michigan hanging around through really the middle of the third rotation now at this point, down just a point.
Central's having a good meet so far. They can keep it rolling, close that gap a little bit on Michigan State. Skyla coming with her leap pass. Switch leap half to a leap jump.
Schulte out of Bolingbrook, Illinois, the last score a 9.875, a career high of 9.95.
Absolutely. She'll definitely look to get that 9.9 or higher score, as her teammates have done thus far in the rotation. The cane spring layout step out. Solid finish for her. Nice confidence. Michigan State's really attacking the skills on beam this afternoon. They're showing a lot of composure. Skyla does a switch leap into her gainer full dismount and gets a stick as well. Michigan State is rolling on balance beam.
And honestly, I think we heard a few oohs and ahs from the crowd after that one. The dismount and the stick, that was lethal from her.
Yes, a very well done routine for her for sure. You can hear the go green, go white erupt from the stands after that.
Back to Central Michigan and Haley Hornbacher for the Chippewas.
Haley did a beautifully done double tuck there. Nice height on that skill.
This, for the Chippewas, is a unit that's ranked 37th in the country. And for Hornbacher out of Caro, Michigan, her recent score at 9.9.
That might get close today. Getting that chain again. Oh, and it's a fork, I think they were handing her. Bailey Garcia is mounting the beam for Michigan State. She's the fifth competitor in the lineup.
Garcia, another one who has a last score of 9.9 to her name. Out of Boynton Beach, Florida, she's another one who has the same career high as Schulte at 9.95.
And Skyla did get a 9.95 for that last routine. Bailey did a beautiful back handspring layout step out. That was nice and floaty in the air. Bailey moves through balance beam in a very fluid manner. She looks calm and at ease up there. Front aerial into a split jump. Again, nice 180-degree split positioning on that split jump. And switch leap, split jump again for her leap pass. All Bailey has left in the routine is her dismount coming up here. She has a back handspring gainer full, looks for the stick, and she gets it. Michigan State has been nailing these routines. And again, that was Bailey's last routine as a senior. She gets the carnation thrown for her. What a way to finish on her last routine at home for balance beam.
Yet another Michigan State athlete to wear the crown of thorns here today at Jennison Fieldhouse. As you see them being picked up off the mat, and wow.
Michigan State is rocking it for sure on that rotation over there on balance beam. We're looking back to Central. Double tuck on that last pass for the floor routine.
Ashley Veglucci here, 9.85, her most recent score. There's a embrace from Coach Mike Rowe with Bailey Garcia. And what are the emotions like as you're going through this final day here in front of the home crowd? What are some of the thoughts?
So it's interesting because it's not the last time they're going to compete total. They have more meets to come, of course. However, it's the last time competing inside of Jenison. So it's a little bit of a dynamic of sadness that knowing it's the last time you're going to compete here, but also you know there's still more gymnastics to come. So it's definitely highs and lows as the day progresses. But Bailey's had a fantastic career at Michigan State. She's been a key contributor for them all 4 years that she's been here. So and I know she appreciates this moment.
I think there you're seeing a little bit of the emotion, certainly, from Garcia as we're moving back to Central Michigan, who's on the floor here. It was a 9.9 for Vic Lucci in the last routine on floor. Amber Mueller up next for the Chippewas here. But though, it's Gabby Steven on the beam for Michigan State.
Gabby did her front aerial to 2 feet. Typically, those are done when you land on 1 foot only and step forward. She made a little bit of a correction after that landing, but masked it very well.
Steven, one of the products out of suburb Chicago, particularly Elgin, Illinois, last score of 9.8, but yet another gymnast who has a career high of 9.95.
Michigan State has a lot of scoring potential, certainly, on balance beam from these competitors. They've been showing that this afternoon. Gabby had an adjustment on her series. So they have very solid scores prior to Gabby. My bet is this will be their routine score that they will dismiss or not count in their rotation. Not to say it's a bad score, certainly, but she's had a few little minor corrections here and there. And she's finishing up with her round off double fold dismount. We'll see if she can get the stick to cap things off. And she does. Well done, Michigan State, on balance beam.
Strong, strong third rotation. And I think that's fair to say, really, about quite a few of these schools and squads here have had nice aspects of their days today. For Michigan State and Central Michigan, both the floor and the beam proved to be excellent here.
You're exactly right. And I don't know the exact team total for Central, but I believe that was probably their highest score per the rotation of the afternoon. They did a great job on those floor routines. Got some solid scores across the board for those.
And the way it looks, as you see there, is Michigan State in front by just north of a point at 148.525. The Chippewas following in tow, 147.475. And you're seeing a look at Michigan State's Kayla Tucker.
Michigan State has a couple of exhibition competitors to go. A couple of the seniors, again, where they're getting those opportunities to compete one last time here on their home turf.
As we're seeing a look at the Golden Fork, I wonder exactly what you would be able to eat with that. I'm not entirely sure. It's like you'd want to be wearing a grill while you're using the Golden Fork.
I'm sure there is some kind of insight into that, some kind of inside joke maybe that the fork is what is passed around amongst each other. We're looking at Naya Smith on beam for this initial exhibition routine. A little bit off on her backhand spring layout. She let her hips open to the side, so she had to make a correction to close that back and keep her center right back over the balance beam.
And we talked about the opportunity a little bit earlier of Nikki and Naya Smith to compete together, and that's coming to a close here rather shortly, but just tremendous to see that she is here contributing and will continue to do so over the remaining couple weeks.
You're exactly right. I can only imagine what that would be like to compete in Big Ten gymnastics with your sister on the same team. She was graced that extra year with the COVID scenario to be able to compete for her fifth year, which is right now. So to do it for 2 years in a row with her sister has to be exceptional for them. A nice punch front on beam. Another one of those skills that not many gymnasts are willing to take the risk on because it's such a difficult one to land without taking deductions for. Nice to see that difficulty showing from Naya. You'll see the same similar difficulty in this dismount. She does a round off double tuck and nearly sticks it, just a small step forward. The beautiful routine for Naya.
there, as we're seeing Michigan State. They are now finished, it looks like, and oh my goodness gracious.
This is actually Nicole Jones's family, parents and kiddos. They made the big Jumbotron today.
And
here's
there
Mama.
Is Coach Jones for Michigan State. After, I'm not sure she had a look at her family.
Probably
on the Jumbotron.
Not.
No,
she's pretty focused.
Fixated on what's happening here today.
And Sydney Hayashi mounting the beam.
Worth noting that it's Hayashi's second exhibition performance of the day today.
Sydney had some creative dance. Her presence on balance beam is nice to see. So she bent at her waist on that leap skill. It'll be a sizable deduction from the judges, but again, she saved having a fall, certainly. The handspring layout step out. Beautiful execution throughout that skill. See a little bit of nerves from her, just not quite certain of herself. Without competing too many times on beam, this is definitely one where the nerves can creep in. Beautifully done front toss, though. Nice landing on that. She is finishing up here with her dismount. Gainer full off the end and gets the stick. And the flowers. Great way for her to finish inside Jennison.
And so with that, we're as close as can be to finishing the third rotation. Stick with us here for just a couple more moments, as what we're seeing is a 148.525 to 147.475.
You can see some of the raw emotion here as Sydney gets hugs from everybody all around.
Heading down now as we're beginning another interview with Layla Pascal alongside Greenville head coach. Here we go.
Welcome back to the mat. Alongside me is Zach Peters, head coach of Greenville's gymnastics team. How does it feel going into your next event with the scores that you have? What are the scores you're hoping to see?
Yeah, you know, we're actually going to be pretty close to breaking our school record for all four events. So we're really hoping even just get a 45. It's a 9 average. It's not very good. And they can do higher than that. But if they go 9 average, we break a school record, and I'd be happy with that. So that's really our biggest goal right now. So
amazing. And currently, what is the mindset of being in the quad meet and how you have prepared for it? And what is it going to prepare you for by the end of today?
Yeah, you know, I told the girls, like, hey, this is a big meet, lots of energy, great crowd, great gymnastics. We got to focus on us, though. So obviously, energy, use that. And they have all day today. It's been super fun. We've had some of the best routines we've had all year long. And going forward from this, you know, again, they're going to break the school record. We'll be like, yep, we needed that energy. And we have to thank the fans for that one. So
amazing. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Layla Pascal, and you're watching Gymnastics on Big Ten Plus.
What a word there from Zach Peters, the head gymnastics coach at Greenville University. And I think the key thing to take away there is that they're approaching the school record on a few different events here for Greenville.
They are, you're right. So they're, as he was mentioning, they are looking at possibly eclipsing their school record for a team total. So as we talked about in the beginning of the meet today, it's not always about wins and losses, but more so staying within yourself and looking towards some of those NQS scores and building upon your prior scores. So if Greenville can come out strong on bars here and surpass their school record, that would be a phenomenal finish for them today. Just getting a look back at Skyla's prior routine from balance beam.
And there is the regrouped Bailey Garcia for Michigan State. Now, if you're Michigan State and you're headed into rotation four and looking to put a cap on what has happened today, and especially with the emotions of senior day, how do you rein that back in and what do you look for them on the floor?
So Michigan State has come out big today so far. They've had great scores on all three rotations. They really just need to come to floor and do what they know they're capable of doing. They don't want to overthink it. They don't want to try too hard. Sometimes if you try to stick landings or focus too much on some of those finite opportunities, you can kind of make some little mistakes here and there. So if they can come out and just have a good time on floor and rely upon their training, they'll be doing an awesome job.
And now in just a few seconds here, we'll be having an inside look at Central Michigan Gymnastics as we're getting set to go as a part of the fourth rotation here, Michigan State, getting ready on the floor as you're seeing Coach Mike Rowe there. And it'll be us sending it down to Layla Pascal with Central Michigan's head coach. Layla, take it away.
Thanks for joining us one more time down here on the mat for our final interview with Coach from Central Michigan. How are you feeling about it being senior day and celebrating all of the girls?
It's an exciting time of year. We're really proud of each and every one of our seniors and from seniors from every team, right? They've been working so hard over these 4, maybe 5 years. So to have these moments for them, it's really special.
And Christine, how does it feel to be in the energy of a quad meet? How has it supported the girls and what can they take away from tonight?
It's very representative of what a conference championship will be like. So the energy, the noise level, it all really brings that energy back. We've been doing, you know, dual meets where it's you alternating here, you're with your group, you're coming as a team, event to event. So I think it's a great experience. It's been a wonderful day.
Amazing. Thank you so much for your time and joining us here for this interview. Great luck on the rest of the meet today. I'm Layla Pascal. Thank you so much for joining us.
And it's been interesting to see as now there's Ellie Beaufay, who we highlighted.
Yes, Ellie is the leadoff competitor from Michigan State. She opens with a front double full. She has more of a graceful presence on floor. We'll see some more of the high energy type of dancing and music as the rotation proceeds.
Beaufay out of Columbus, Michigan has been close to a 10 a time or two, but her recent score at 9.875.
Yes, she's been a solid leadoff for Michigan State all season long. Just coming back with her round off 1.5 front layout. Some of the down on the floor dance here. It is a requirement per the floor routine that the gymnast is actually down on the floor at some point during the routine. This gives the gymnast a chance to kind of catch their breath also. And she's finishing with her last pass. Punch Rudy. That's a 1.5. And nicely done on the landing. Again, another solid leadoff routine from Ellie Beaufay.
And I think for her, the evaluation will be interesting, but I know one of the points that we hit on earlier in the meet was that your routines build up, right? But with her, she has the capability of going a really, really high score early to solidify the floor for Michigan State.
You're exactly right. Judges tend to throw a little bit higher scores toward the end of a rotation versus the opening. So if they can start that high with Ellie's routine, then it only goes up from there. That was a nicely done Yurchenko layout full for Central. A little bit off close to that line on the left of the landing mat. I don't think she stepped over it, though, which means there will be no deduction for that landing.
And that was Jenna Germond out of Neshanic, Pennsylvania, who really is leading off for a team that's ranked 30th in the country on the vault. But she, I think, you know, there were very few blemishes to what she just accomplished there. There, as it's a look between Nia Smith and Skylar Schulte. It'll be Smith, who's on the floor at this moment in time, out of West Bloomfield. Her last score, a 9.875.
And Yurchenko layout full again. Solid vaults from Central. And we're looking at Nia Smith here for floor. She has upgraded her opening tumbling pass this year from last year. She does a full end to start. Well done on that landing. She could see the floor. Jumped into her lunge positioning. It could take a slight deduction for her chest being down just a bit, but she covered that well. Now it's time to just have a little fun. And our leap pass, switch leap, switch side, straddle full. Some of that change of dynamic from Ellie's graceful routine to more of the dance style, the party style here coming from Nia. Doing her front through to double tuck to finish the routine out. Beautifully done there on that landing. Her chest was completely vertical as she finished. And she puts on her crown.
Here come the roses. And what a way to finish. I think that's been the storyline for these Michigan State seniors that are finishing out and completing their careers here in Jenison. They have all been performing to a very high standard.
You're exactly right. And sometimes on senior night, it's hard to not let that emotion take control. So to still do the gymnastics that you know you can do versus trying to do too much or too little or make corrections that aren't necessary. So it's fun to see them compete to their capability and finish on a high note this afternoon. Nice series from Fisk, but handspring layout step out. She comes back with an aerial into a split jump.
This Anaya Taylor for Fisk on the beam.
And switch leap split quarter for her leap series. Routine so far for her. She looks confident up there. Finishing with her dismount, a punch front full, and a small little hop forward. That was a beautiful routine for Fisk.
And for Taylor out of Cornelius, North Carolina, her high score to this point was a 9.625 over on the beam.
That should trump that, I would imagine. Greenville on bars. Moving through some circling elements on that low bar up to a high bar change. Giant into toe front and small step forward. A hit routine for Greenville.
Central entering the vault here.
Yurchenko layout full, a sizable hop backwards on that landing. judges can take quite a bit of a deduction for the amount of distance she covered on that hop. And we're jumping into Michaela Tucker's floor routine. She opened strong.
Tucker, her last score was a 9.925. It's quite difficult, I think it goes without saying, to push a score higher than that. But with that being said, she can do it.
She's certainly capable, yes. She started off strong so far. We'll see what she can come back with for this last pass. She does a front double full. Nicely done there.
It's worth noting, I think, that Tucker's 9.925 was her career high. That just occurred.
We'll see what they give her. That was a nice routine so far.
Headed on over to Greenville University here on the bars. In this unit here for Greenville, ranked 84th in the country, and what's kind of interesting to me actually is that a few athletes of theirs have not competed on the bars since just about middle February.
So it's hard to know what that reasoning would be. Sometimes if there are injuries at play, they've had to go deeper into their lineups to get competitors that can do the full routines through. But if that's the case, she's doing a great job so far. Finishes with that double tuck dismount and a hit routine for Greenville. Delaney had nice control in her opening pass of a full in there.
Harkness with the last score of 9.925 for her, and the career high at 9.95 as well.
Delaney comes with her elite pass. Nicely done. Again, that full 180 degree split positioning, as well as closure of the wolf full to finish the skill. Delaney again doing the down on the floor portion of the floor routine. She's moving through for her last pass. She does a front tuck through to a roundback handspring double tuck. Nice landing positioning again. Her chest is all the way vertical. Took that controlled lunge backwards to finish the skill. Nice routine for Michigan State. And again, the Carnations. Delaney's last routine at home.
We might as well have a rose parade around East Lansing, Michigan here today.
It's fun when your last routine can be on floor. That makes it even that much better as the last rotation.
And there you see what I believe to be family hugs there for Delaney Harkness. And I think this isn't something that I want to say as being probable, but as it looks, Michigan State might be in order for what could be a very high score.
You're exactly right. They have potential of eclipsing that 198 mark, which is kind of the coveted number in collegiate gymnastics. They do have to compete well and get big scores on this rotation still, so we'll see where they end up landing. Caught the dismount there for Fisk. Nice finish for her. Again, holding that positioning, making sure the judges saw her control at the end.
Competition still raging on here from Jenison Fieldhouse, a Saturday afternoon at what's nearing 4 o'clock Eastern time. And now it's for Michigan State, Nikki Smith on the floor here, her last score, 9.85.
Nikki Smith is capable of big scores, certainly. She opens with this full in. She hardly even touches her legs, which means she uses all that rotation just from amplitude and core strength to get herself all the way around on that skill. And switch leap half, straddle full for her leap pass. Nikki does do a three-pass routine. This is the second of the routine, one and a half. Punch front layout, again, shows good control. Because that was a forward-moving skill, her lunge does come forward of herself. This is a fun little dance sequence here for Nikki. Her teammates tend to do it with her on the sideline. She can play it up to the crowd a little bit here also. Taking a big breath as she readies herself in the corner for her last pass. Finishing here with a round of back handspring. Double tuck, looking for that landing, and she sticks it. Now Nikki's gotten a 10 before. This should be a big score for her. We'll see what they give her.
And to great applause, she finds a way to anchor Michigan State in only the way that she could.
You're exactly right. Michigan State has Skylar Schulte to come yet, so if they can get a big score out of Nikki, Skylar can continue to build upon it as well.
Imagine being able to say that you've just completed an epic run to a great applause that transcends the atmosphere here, and then you have another competitor as well in Schulte.
You're exactly right. Yes, there's more to come yet. One more routine for Michigan State that can count toward the team total. 9.95 was given for Nikki, so very close to that 10.0.
And the way it looks at this moment in time is Michigan State has climbed the ladder all the way to 198.025. So it's the third time in program history they've found a way to get over that 198 threshold. And that, folks, major accomplishment as they are headed on the way into another quad and then Big Tens right back here at Jenison. And then into Nationals. This is a team that can do some damage.
You're exactly right. It's very exciting to see them continue to push forward and move this program to newer heights. Speaking of height, that was very high. Opening pass for Skylar Schulte on that one full in there.
Schulte, her last score, 9.925, and a career high of 9.975. The 10 remaining elusive.
Yep, she's starting off very well so far. We'll see if she can continue on with that trajectory. Nice leap pass for her. She shows beautiful positioning in those straddle jumps especially. She goes above and beyond that 180 position. She has one pass left. It's time to let loose and have fun here. Front through to a double tuck, looking for this landing, and she sticks it. Well done for Skyla. This could be another big score for Michigan State. Very well done by Skylar Schulte. Fantastic meet for the Spartans today.
Poetic. And look at the reaction. All of her team flocks right to her. Michigan State celebrating in droves today.
It's definitely been something special to see these Spartans, like I said, continuing to move this program onward and upward. And again, eclipsing that 198 score. They were able to do so once prior in this season. The other one was last season. They got the 198. We'll see if Skyler can add to the team total with this score.
Oh, my goodness. A 9.975 for Schulte, just short. exactly.
One judge gave her the 10, and one judge gave her a 9.95, so it averages to the 9.975. So one judge gave it to her. Couldn't quite get that other one to get on board.
And I think you could tell with the reaction that they were hungry for that 10 to be completed. With that being said, though, it's a 198.15, so it does elevate just a little bit.
It did. That's a fantastic score for Michigan State. Being that they had a road win at University of Michigan with the 198 prior to the season, that means both of these scores, they had to drop that 198, I'm sorry, at University of Michigan, but this 198 will now count in their RQS score.
And it's in the first exhibition spot, Gianna Khalifi for Michigan State. And I think, though, as speaking about the meet against Michigan, that was where the tide turned a little bit for Michigan State. That was where they discovered just how far they could go. That was where they grew into another level of confidence. And since then, they've been on an absolute tear.
You're exactly right. Early in the season, you know, you're still looking to kind of find some of those little details, stuck landings, perfect execution throughout, skills. So they were still building some of those things at the point in the season they were competing at University of Michigan. So you're right, Brian, past that meet, they've really been able to kind of hone in on some of those details and continue to build scores from that point forward.
And I think it's those details that will be the catalyst for Michigan State in the national competitions as well, that if you ask anybody, whether it be staff or athletes, that they were just a little bit off of where they had to be to make it through at the national meet just a year ago. So it'll be a fixation on the minute details this year.
You're exactly right. The details in gymnastics are really what make or break when you get down to postseason and those little finite deductions at Big Tens, at regionals, at trying to qualify into nationals, and certainly when you get to nationals itself, which is what Michigan State's looking to do. And beautiful routine for Michigan State again. They're continuing to show their depth, show they have routines in their back pocket they can still plug and play with in any rotation. And again, seniors get to finish out their last meet, get hugs from family.
It's a bouquet out this time for Gianna Khalifi as she finished there and was adorned with roses once more. And folks, we do have just a few more routines to work through here. As it stands, it's Michigan State, 198.150. Central Michigan following suit with a 196.425. And then it's Fisk with 192.925. And then it's Greenville with a 189.75. And I think, you know, what's unique, speaking about a few of these programs, such as the Fisk of the world, is that they're new to the scene. But yet, they're putting up a score like 192.
A very respectable
score,
absolutely.
On the verge to 193. And you wonder what can happen with a few more years of development and recruiting class. And there they go.
You're exactly right. And we heard head coach talk about the youth they have on their program. They're only in their second season of having a program entirely. So by the nature of that, you tend to have younger gymnasts, of course. So they're still learning how to compete in this collegiate platform. And again, there aren't many times that you have these quad meet settings where there's so much going on all at once. So that in and of itself is a little bit of a learning curve, but they're handling it beautifully. Leap pass, switch leap, straddle quarter. Nicely done there. And the unique cartwheel she did to switch foot cartwheel, so she started and finished on the same leg there. And finishes with her gainer pike off the end for the dismount. Nicely done, a sigh of relief there after she finished that routine. have one more competitor on the floor. Naomi, waiting for her turn in this last exhibition spot. Looks like there's a little bit of a judging discussion for the prior routine from Gianna. They're getting that score settled before being able to salute for Naomi.
So when you're over on the judges panel, are you having a discussion? Are you kind of gauging where the other's score is? Do you want to be independent? How does that work?
Interesting question, actually, Brian. So the judges should be focused only on that routine by itself. I did mention, though, scores tend to build. They shouldn't technically do that because it should be based on exactly what they're seeing in front of their eyes. However, there's some subjectivity in it as well, so it's not intended to be a comparison between gymnasts, but it does happen that way sometimes. So Naomi opens with a double tuck, a very high double tuck. I think she stayed in bounds. Her foot might have touched the line on the far side, but as long as you don't step over the line, there's no deduction for that. And if I'm not mistaken, this is the first time we're seeing Naomi's floor routine on the season here. 1.5 front layout. You can tell she's having a good time. And her leap pass. Switch leap half, wolf full. Coming back for her last tumbling pass to finish out the routine. North by handspring, double pike. Again, sky high, beautifully done. Nice control on that landing. And great job for Naomi. What a moment as a senior.
The go green, go white now is flowing throughout Jennison, and we're seeing hugs all around, as we've seen many a time here on this fine afternoon from East Lansing, Michigan. But with that being said, that's the finale for Michigan State, and now it'll be a situation where the teams are set to gather together and have the awards to cap out our time here. But what were your impressions as we look across at the different teams that we've seen and some of the individual standouts? What did you see?
So definitely some great gymnastics across the board today. It was nice to see where if a mistake happened here or there, programs were still able to adjust from that mistake, have hit routines following those mistakes. It's inevitable that in this sport of gymnastics, you're going to have things that don't quite go the way you wanted them to go. So seeing that adversity come through, but then being able to adjust to that and still have good routines after the fact is one of those key things to be able to produce. Michigan State, of course, I think they went hit every routine that they put up today, even the exhibition routines. So again, showing that depth that they have leading in the postseason, that gives them a little bit of cushion. It's fun to see that 198 today.
Still a look there at Naomi German. The Spartans found a way to get it done today, and it was really at what I would regard as one of the highlights of the program's time. But here is a look at a series of highlights from today's action.
Perfect. That was a nice dismount from Central. The series for Greenville on beam, back handspring, layout step out. She has nice lift on that layout step out skill. Delaney coming back with her ginger, legs glued all the way together the whole way through. And central beam routine still. Looking at some of the creativity in the dance and the down on the beam. And as Fisk is finishing full pirouette to a double tuck. Nice job. You can see the excitement from the coaches on the sideline there and the joy from the teammates. This is a good look at the difficulty from Naya's dismount. Round off back double tuck.
Well, Michigan State did get pushed today. They found a way to get it done. We'll be right back after a short break here on Big Ten Plus. Well, with that being said, Sarah, we're back here live where the teams are on the floor and it's the seniors for each squad who are being acknowledged with roses of their own from the hands of Michigan State competitors.
Yes, the Michigan State seniors are doling out flowers to the seniors on the other team, so it's kind of funny watching them run back and forth here. Pretty cool acknowledgement, though.
It certainly is. It certainly is. And from there, we'll go into, presumably, the awards that are given out for each high score and such.
Yes, the seniors from Michigan State especially have been huge contributors to moving this program forward. So it'll be lots of kudos to them for everything they've done for the program in the last 4 or 5 years for a couple of them that were able to do their additional year.
So it was just acknowledged that Elizabeth Cesarone enters a tie for third.
This is on vault. They'll do awards in Olympic order as well, so vault bars, beam, floor.
Yes. Sage Kellerman then for Michigan State also in that tie. Then Gabby Steven acknowledged for Michigan State.
That first place position today for vault.
Michaela Tucker here will head on to the podium for Michigan State.
Both of the sticks this afternoon on their 1.5s.
Morgan Price, who we anticipated would be the key difference maker for Fisk University, she was right there.
Absolutely, 9.9 for her on a bar routine. That was a great score for Fisk for sure.
Jory Jackard acknowledged for Michigan State as well on the bars there. Gabby Steven for the Spartans, and well, it's been Michigan State heavily here.
Right. And being that Michigan State was the high scorer, obviously, of the meet today, we'll likely see mostly Spartans up on the podium. But they were personal victories as well as team victories with all the programs today. So it was nice to see everybody have a good competition in and amongst themselves as well.
Headed to the beam now. It's Bailey Garcia for Michigan State. Gianna Khalifi as well was in a tie there, drawing her even with Garcia.
And they've had the parents of the seniors giving out the flowers.
And Skyla Schulte found a way to carry the day for Michigan State on the bars.
actually balance beam there for the girls. Took 1, 2, and 3 for Michigan State. They did not count a score below a 9-9 today on the beam rotation, which was phenomenal.
Now it's Delaney Harkness for the Spartans. Nikki Smith then as well here for Michigan State. And then it was Schulte again who notches a second event win, but on the floor there finished with what was a 9.975.
Yeah. Just shy of that 10-0 perfect score. Great rotation again for Michigan State.
So
Morgan
it's more.
Price, she actually got her same score, 39.275, which what had previously been her all-around best. She tied that for herself today, so she had a phenomenal meet today. Great job for Morgan.
Then it's Central Michigan there, but noticing immediately some ice, it looks like, on the left knee there, the wear and tear of being the second place all-around finisher.
Pretty typical, yes. Using some ice just to offset some nagging injuries that are inevitable after as many years of gymnastics as these ladies have done.
And it's Skyla Schulte who found a way to solidify her place as the all-around winner here today. So it is true that Greenville finishes at 189.75. The belief is that that's their program high, so kudos to Greenville for competing at a high level that they did here today. And really, each of these teams pushed Michigan State, as you see Central Michigan with a 196.425, and then a 198.150 for Michigan State, finding a way to eclipse 198, winning another quad, and wow, they're really doing it, pushing into the end of this season here. 2024, been a banner year for the Michigan State Spartans.
You're exactly right, Brian. It's been so fun to see the Spartans continue to move forward with this program and getting those high, high scores that are so coveted in the NCAA gymnastics.
For a few of these teams, they'll be hopping on a plane and some on a bus. Michigan State just walking back to wherever they must go. Thank you so much for being here with us as a part of this quad event at Michigan State University. It's Brian Rector alongside Sarah Sageman. Sarah, thank you. Everyone listening, we're so glad you could join us on this Saturday. Have a great evening.